All right, now let's discuss methods of proof.
Okay, now we've discussed the conditions under which arguments are valid, but independent of this, we might want to know that an argument is valid, or we might want to just show that it's valid. And for that, we're going to need proof. Now, the proofs that we're going to study are deductive, and deductive proofs are held to the highest standard of rigor. As we saw before, deductive validity requires that if the premises are true, the conclusion must necessarily be true. Contrast these with inductive. For instance, consider the following argument. The sky is cloudy, so it will rain. This is an inductive argument, but it's not deductively valid, because it's very possible that the sky be cloudy, but that it not rain. In fact, even a high degree of probability is not enough to get us a deductively rigorous argument. Consider, for instance, the following. Granted, even though I bought one lottery ticket, it's very, very unlikely that I will win the lottery. So there's a pretty high degree of certitude here. But that's not enough to make a deductively rigorous argument. So arguments like these count as inductive. There's a whole class of logics that deal with inductive arguments, but we won't be dealing with them in this class. We're just dealing with deductive arguments. Now, deductive arguments come in two types, formal and informal. The majority of the arguments we're going to construct for this course are formal. If you go on to take classes in more advanced subjects in logic, typically the proofs are informal. The important thing to keep in mind here is that there is no difference in rigor between formal and informal arguments. It's just a style of presentation. So what does it mean to give a formal argument? Well, in a formal argument, we have a series of premises from which we derive conclusions, and we justify these by appealing to rules. This is what allows us to prove rigorously that any number of conclusions follow from the premises. Each step in a deductive proof is justified by appealing to a rule. And much of what follows is an examination of and application of rules that we adopt in the Fitch system, which we'll discuss in a moment. The takeaway point just is that for a formal deductive proof, each line in the proof has to be justified by appealing to a rule and possibly also to premises. You don't need to use all the premises necessarily, but you have to have each line justified by an appeal to these so that there are no logical gaps. And in just a moment, we'll discuss the first of these rules, which governs the identity symbol or equals.